Hello Reminders, in this video, I'm going to show you how we can create chatbot app using MIT App Inventor with the help of OpenAI. So first of all, open the appinventor.mit.edu, then click on start new project. And my project name is chatbot OpenAI. And then click on OK. So I'm going to design this app first. So in the left side, you will find the layout. Click on this. And I'm going to use here one vertical scroll arrangement. This one. Okay, this one, and make this width and height is fill parent like this. And I'm going to use here one horizontal arrangement, this one, just drag and drop this here and make this one is width is fill parent like this. Now I'm going to use here one text box where we can ask question to the AI. So in the left side, you will find text box. And as you can see here, one button, we are going to use here one button also like this. Click on this button and just say send. Like this, and I'm to make this width is 20% like this. I'm going to use here one default color, background color going to be green something, and I'm to change that text color to the white, and I'm to change the size of this font like 16, and click on the text box and make this width is 70% at least like this. Click on horizontal arrangement and make this both in a center like this. Cool. Now that's our design here. Now I'm going to change that design. I'm going to change the vertical arrangement color to be the white like this. And this one is also the white again like this. Cool. Now I'm going to use your one label to display our chat like this. And in that here AI response like this for the initial. Okay. For the first stage. Like this. So that's our app. Okay, design. Now let's use one plugin here. Okay, so go to the Google and just search here OpenAPI App Inventor extension. So as you can see here, that artificial intelligence and OpenAI extension, I will give you the link in the description. So open that link and scroll down and you will find the AIX file. Just download this AIX file, allow. Now go to the MIT App Inventor. In the left side, you'll find the extension. Click on import extension. Click on choose file. Import the extension. Click on import. Now drag and drop this extension here like this. Now go to the block section here. And whenever someone click on this button, okay, button one. So we have to send question, okay, to the AI. So click on open AI. Okay. And as you can see here, we need to call the this call open AI chat. So just call this here. In the prompt, we are going to use your text box one dot text. This one, simple. Model I will use ADA is fine. And now the API key. Now how we can get that? So open the new tab, search here, OpenAI API, platform.openai.com. Just open this site. I will give you the link of this also in the description. Now after the login to the this platform.open.ai, you need to go to the your account. And then click on view API keys and you need to click on that create new secret key. And then you need to copy your key. Copy this key, go to the again App Inventor here. Now you can use one variable here like this. And the variable name is API key. And I'll use here one text, just paste your API key here. And I'm going to use here this API key like this. I will just change this to API key like this. Now what I will do here, I need a max token. So I'm going to use here one max token is going to be 300 is fine. And this is the informative. This is the true and false. Okay. So suppose if you want to get a response of any question in a deep. Okay. So you have to choose this is false. If you want to make the answer is creative, then you need to make it false. So I will make it false. I need a short and creative answer. So that's why I will make it false like this. Done. Now we are sending that question to the AI. Okay. We are generating the answer from that question. Okay. Now how we can get a response. So click on OpenAI and as you can see here, got response. So once we got the response, then we have to display that response in the label. Okay. So how we can do this? So we are going to show that response in the label one, this one, label one dot text. I will just set this like here. Okay. And now I'm going to use your one text and use this one join. And in the first, I will use here one normal text is like slash n, okay, like this, to make text in a new line. And again, I need to use here one more is like this, and I can just say here it's you, okay, like this. And I'm going to use here one more text here to join this, like this, and one more. I need a four here. So in the third one, I will just use here the question, because I have to display the question also, okay, what I have asked. So I will use the text box one dot text like this. And again, I'm going to use here a space, okay, it means in the new line. I need an answer in a new line. So I will use again this, and I'm going to use here one more a string to get the answer. So this is the response. So get this like this here. Okay, now after just whenever someone click on this and we got an answer, so we have to just make sure this text box one dot text value should be null. So you can type another question here, okay, like this. Otherwise you have to remove your previous text manually. So I will just remove the text like this. We have used your token spanned, so we need to change that token spanned to the response. Sorry for that, like this. Done. And let's try this. Open the Connect AI Companion. What do you think about Elon Musk? Okay, let's send it. So as you can see, as approach to his Elon Musk approach to his electricity restoration business is etc. So you are getting the answer of any question. So that's the amazing app. If you need any help on that, just comment on the video. I'll try my best to solve your problems. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.